Under unconfoundedness, a regression is going to give you a causal effect. Now, it's not necessarily going to give you exactly the average treatment effect or the average treatment on the treated, but the reason is more technical and mathematical, so we'll just skip it, okay? But it will give you a causal effect. So in addition to just doing ordinary regression, there's a very, very, very large number of alternative approaches that can be used to compute average treatment effects under the unconfoundedness assumption. These are usually called matching methods. Now, they're very similar to regression. The basic idea is you want to compare units that have the same values of the covariates, but different values of the treatments, because you want to look within those variables. You're assuming that treatment's randomly assigned, so you want to look for at people who have the same value of the variables, but different treatment variables. So how are you going to do this? Well, what we're going to do is take a treated unit, and then find a non-treated unit that has very, very similar covariate values, okay? So they have the same gender, they both have the same amount of education, roughly, they both make about the same amount of income, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. That pair is called a match. Now, what we're gonna do is write down the difference in the outcome between the treated unit and the untreated unit in that pair, in that match. And then we're gonna make a bunch of pairs like this using all of our data. Then that's gonna give us a list of treatment differences. And then what we can do is just take a weighted average of this list, and that's gonna give us either the average treatment effect or the average treatment on the treated, depending on how we do the weighting. That's basically all there is to matching. There's a lot of different ways to pick the pairs, which how you match people, but all of them have the same basic idea. You wanna find people who have similar values of the covariates, who look the same, basically. One of the most popular ways of doing this is called propensity score matching. Now, the propensity score is just a number, a single number, that summarizes all of that unit's covariates. So by first computing this number for everybody, you then can just compare units along that single number, find people who have very similar values of the propensity score, and then you do the matching analysis the same as before. Match a treated unit with a non-treated unit, who both have very similar values of the propensity score, write down the difference in their outcomes, do that for everybody in your data, and then take the average difference. And that'll give you your average treatment effect.